The AH-64 Apache stands not merely as an attack helicopter. It epitomizes the very essence of what an attack helicopter should be. With almost four decades of active service, it has participated in numerous conflicts, carving out a formidable reputation amidst the heat of battle. The Apache has demonstrated unparalleled versatility, reliability, and lethality, making it an indispensable asset on battlefields all around the world. Even though modern battlefields and rapidly advancing man-portable air defense systems pose an increasing threat to attack helicopters, the AH-64 Apache remains the most intimidating attack helicopter out there. It is a warrior worthy of its name. During the Cold War, the United States Army pursued a new aircraft that would attack the Soviet armor columns and decimate them. The Air Force had their A-10 Thunderbolt II and the Marine Corps AV-8A Harrier. So the Army wanted something similar. The obstacle arose from the 1948 Key West Agreement, which prevented the US Army from owning fixed-wing combat aircraft. This bureaucratic hurdle meant that the Army's next aircraft had to be a helicopter, yet one that was significantly more powerful than the current AH-1 Cobra helicopters. Moreover, the new helicopter needed to possess the maneuverability for low-altitude, terrain-hugging flights, known as Nap of the Earth, or NOE flying, allowing it to use the landscape for concealment and stealth. Fortunately, the US Army got an attack helicopter that changed everything and became a military aviation cornerstone. When AH-68 Apache first entered service in 1986, it was one of a kind. No rotary wing aircraft in the world had the technology and firepower it possessed, and it would take decades before someone came up with anything that would be even close. The US Army received its money's worth when a total of 277 AH-64s took part, destroying 278 tanks, numerous armored personnel carriers, and other Iraqi vehicles for a total of over 500 kills during the 100-hour ground war of Operation Desert Storm. Only one Apache was lost. This is an achievement that's very hard to match. Now, let's take a closer look at this rotary wing legend. AH-64 Apache is a big helicopter, considerably bigger and heavier than the AH-1 Cobra helicopters. It is 58 feet 3 inches long, 15 feet 3 inches high, and has a main rotor diameter of 48 feet. It possesses a loaded weight of 17,650 pounds and a maximum takeoff weight of 23,000 pounds. The Apache is powered by two General Electric T700 GE turboshaft engines, delivering up to 2,000 horsepower, facilitating impressive maneuverability and speed. It can reach top speeds of up to 187 miles per hour and has a cruising speed of 171 miles per hour. This aircraft also has a remarkable service ceiling of 21,000 feet with a climb rate of up to 2,500 feet per minute. The AH-64's range is another testament to its robustness, boasting a ferry range of 1,024 miles with longbow radar mast mounted assembly and longbow Hellfire missiles. Its combat radius is 260 miles, ensuring significant operational reach. Being a close combat attack aircraft, the Apache is built to withstand serious amounts of punishment in the heat of battle. The AH-64 Apache's design prioritizes crew safety and aircraft durability, especially under fire. Its crew compartment and rotor blades can endure impacts from 23mm rounds thanks to an airframe fortified with approximately 2,500 pounds of armor and a fuel system engineered to seal itself in case of damage, mitigating the risk from ballistic threats. Additionally, a clear protective barrier is placed between the pilot and the gunner to enhance survivability if one of them is directly hit, though the canopy and windows do not offer similar ballistic protection. To further ensure the safety of its crew, the Apache has been constructed to meet the stringent standards of MIL-STD-1290. This military standard outlines the essential criteria for minimizing injury and death through the absorption of crash impact energy. The helicopter meets these requirements by integrating structural reinforcements, crash-resistant landing gear, seating, and a fuel system designed to withstand significant impacts, safeguarding the crew in extreme situations. Operated by a crew of two, the pilot and co-pilot, or gunner, or CPG, the AH-64 Apache offers a dual control system. Both the pilot, seated at the rear of the tandem cockpit, and the CPG, seated at the front, are capable of flying the aircraft and performing the mission independently. This split responsibility, often with the pilot focusing on maneuvering the aircraft while the CPG engages targets, increases operational effectiveness and survivability. The AH-64 Apache includes integrated avionics and electronics, such as the Target Acquisition Designation Sight Pilot Night Vision System, or TADS-PNVS, passive infrared countermeasures, GPS, and the IHADSS, or Integrated Helmet and Digital Sighting System, which is one of the most interesting features of this remarkable aircraft. IHADSS provides pilotage and fire control imagery from separate forward-looking infrared, or FLIR, sensors mounted on the nose of the aircraft. The system presents the eyes with two separate inputs. The right eye views the FLIR imagery, and the left eye views the external world, including the interior cockpit. These two views differ in color, resolution, FOV, motion content, and brightness. Flight symbology is integrated into the HMD imagery. When it comes to armaments, stating that the Apache is armed to the teeth would not be an overstatement. Let's start with Apache's 30mm M230 Chain Gun, which is the only built-in weapon in the helicopter. Frankly, this gun deserves a video of its own. Chain guns are unique. They use a single barrel and bolt driven by a mechanical chain and motor instead of the heat from the bullet's discharge. This design means the firing rate is controlled by the motor's speed, and any misfired rounds get ejected, enhancing the gun's reliability. As part of this design tradition, the M230 chain gun cannon is powered by a 2-horsepower electric motor capable of firing linkless ammunition at a rate of approximately 625 rounds per minute. For practical purposes, the air-cooled weapon maintains a firing rate of around 300 rounds per minute, requiring a 10-minute cooldown after sustained use. The design includes safety features, such as a mechanism to prevent ammunition cook-off to safely clear an open bolt, and safeguards against double feeding of rounds. Expended shells are discarded through the bottom of the weapon, directly out of the aircraft. The gun's mounting system on the AH-64 is operated by secondary hydraulic systems, allowing for precise control. It adjusts elevation through a hydraulic actuator located centrally, just ahead of the pivot, ensuring that the gun can return to a neutral, stowed position with the barrel tilted up by 11 degrees in case of hydraulic failure. This design feature specifically aims to protect the gun by retracting it into a designated space between the pilot stations during a hard landing. The primary ammunition used by the US Apache is the M789, classified as High Explosive Dual Purpose or HEDP rounds. Each cartridge is filled with explosive material encased in a liner designed to focus the explosion into a concentrated jet capable of penetrating 1 inch of rolled homogeneous armor from a distance of 1,650 feet. Additionally, the shell is engineered to fragment upon impact, posing a lethal threat to unarmored personnel within a 5-foot radius under ideal conditions. Remember the IHADSS we just talked about? Well, thanks to this system, either the pilot or gunner can slave the M230 chain gun to their helmets, making the gun track head movements to point where they look. In other words, if they are looking at you and you are playing for the other team, you are dead. Yes, the M230 is a truly devastating weapon, but it is just the tip of the iceberg of the AH-64's heavy loadout. After all, this helicopter was designed to kill tanks. The Apache has 4 hardpoints on subwings and can carry various missiles. Armament is being tailored depending on mission requirements. The most well-known of these weapon systems is the AGM-114 Hellfire. Born and bred to destroy heavy armor, the AGM-114 Hellfire is a family of laser-guided missiles serving as a key component of the US Army. Developed by Boeing and Lockheed Martin, the Hellfire project was initiated in 1974 in response to the pressing requirement for a helicopter-launched air-to-ground missile system that could effectively engage both fixed and moving targets. Originally called the Heli-Borne Laser, a fire-and-forget missile, the nickname Hellfire stuck and eventually became the official name. In optimal conditions, a group of 4 Apache helicopters equipped with a combined arsenal of 64 Hellfire missiles has the capability to obliterate a battalion consisting of 31 T-72 tanks from a distance of 3.7 miles in just a few minutes.
Oh yeah, damn.
The Hellfire AGM-114 missile series exhibits a modular design comprising 5 main sections. The homing head, command and navigation system or CNS, the combat unit, battle component or BC, the control system, the engine and the controls. This family of missiles includes a multitude of models. The AGM-114L is one specific model that has been engineered for exclusive deployment on the Apache Longbow Attack helicopter. This variant uses a millimeter wave or MMW radar seeker, offering effective target engagements within a range of 0.31 and 4.97 miles. The latest variant within this missile family is the AGM-114R, also known as Hellfire Romeo. Designed to replace all previous Hellfire II missile configurations, this version consolidates the capabilities of earlier models into a single, powerful missile system. The Hellfire Romeo is equipped with semi-active laser, or SAL, seekers and has been tailored to counter a wide spectrum of targets, making it a versatile weapon for a variety of military operations. The latest version of the Apaches, the AH-64E Guardian, is capable of being armed with as many as 16 AGM-114R Hellfire II anti-tank guided missiles. For protection against enemy helicopters, this helicopter can be equipped with up to 2 AIM-9 Sidewinders, 4 AIM-92 Stingers, and 4 Mistral air-to-air missiles. Additionally, it can carry 2 AGM-122 sidearm air-to-ground anti-radiation missiles for engaging hostile radar systems. Commonly, the gunship is outfitted with pods that can hold 19 Hydra 70 unguided rockets each. To explore the full potential of this extreme firepower, a very advanced targeting system is installed. Among the most striking features of the AH-64 Apache helicopters are the ANAPG-78 Longbow Fire Control Radar, or FCR, and the Radar Frequency Interferometer, or RFI, both contained within a dome located above the helicopter's main rotor. The heightened positioning facilitates target detection, even when the Apache is obstructed by physical obstacles like terrain features, buildings, or foliage. This variant enables the Apache to fire the AGM-114L Radar Frequency Hellfire missile, enhancing its engagement capabilities. Capable of tracking as many as 128 targets concurrently and engaging up to 16, the ANAPG-78 can initiate an attack within half a minute. Thanks to an integrated radio modem within the sensor suite, the AH-64D Apache Longbow can share vital data with ground troops and other Apaches. This ability to share data enables Apaches to fire on targets that a single helicopter has detected. The front fuselage of the helicopter was expanded to house new systems aimed at increasing survivability, improving navigation, and upgrading tactical internet communications capabilities. The Ukraine-Russia war has demonstrated how vulnerable helicopters can be to man-pads or man-portable air defense systems. This conflict has also become the textbook case for the effective use of UAVs, or unmanned aerial vehicles. The AH-64 Apache, designed as a game changer from the outset, adapts to changing and evolving modern battlefields. The AH-64E Guardian, formerly known as the AH-64D Block 3, features improved digital connectivity, the Joint Tactical Radio System, and the capability to control UAVs. Having a UAV or unmanned aerial vehicle at their disposal enables pilots to survey a broader expanse of the battlefield than is currently possible. Operating at altitudes higher than the Apache and typically positioned at a distance from the helicopter, the UAV allows pilots to not only monitor the vicinity of their location, but also to observe the area surrounding the UAV, which is significantly removed from their position. This capability is referred to as multi-vision, offering a dual perspective of the battlefield. Numerous UAVs are equipped with DL lasers for target illumination, and their DG laser systems are designed to work seamlessly with the missile systems of helicopter gunships. The Apache helicopter leverages this advantage to engage targets from a distance, relying on targeting information provided by UAVs. This strategy allows the Apache to strike while remaining concealed and out of reach of the target's air defense systems or ground troops protecting the target. So what do you think about this remarkable aircraft? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were ever lucky to see an AH-64 Apache up close, or better yet, served in one, please leave a comment.